Hello and welcome to Red Stabler channel. In this video, I'm going to show you how to install Stylelint Visual Studio Code extension and set up linter rules to lint your CSS or SCSS. Let's check it out. So first, let's start with installing the extension. Head to the extension menu and search for Stylelint, then click install. Once the install has finished, click Reload. Now you will see that there's nothing on the console right now. It's because Stylelint is an unopinionated linter and have all the detection rules turned off by default. You will have to create a configuration file and turn on each rule by yourself. Here's the list of the rules that you can turn on. For example, if you want to limit the maximum number of the class selector to 2, you can set the selector max class to 2 in the configuration file. Now there are a couple ways to load a config file to the Stylelint. The first one I'm going to show you is to place it directly into VS Code setting like this. You also want to disable the VS Code default validator to prevent a duplicate warning with Stylelint. Next, I will close and reopen the Visual Studio Code to reload the extension. Now let's try adding more than 2 classes in the selector in the CSS file. You'll see that the Stylelint has detected the rules breaker and showed it on the console. Now if you are working on a project and want to share the customized rules, I recommend you to create a configuration file instead of loading directly to the VS Code. If you are working on a node application, you can add a Stylelint property into package.json like this. But if you are not using Node, another way to load a configuration file is to create a Stylelint RC file into the project folder, and the Stylelint will automatically detect it. At this point, you might wonder if there are any preset rules so you don't have to manually turn on each one. Well, the answer is yes. There is a Stylelint recommended setting for you on GitHub. The link is available on the Stylelint documentation page. Just hit there and copy the setting in index.js and paste it on yours. So, that's it. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Like, subscribe, or follow us on Facebook to stay tuned for the next upload. Thanks for watching and see you next time. Bye.